It's so nice to see you again. How are you
How you
doing?
doing? I'm good. How you doing? How you feeling?
I'm doing good. I'm actually doing great.
As you
So
should
first
be, as you should be.
First and foremost, I just want to give you your flowers for holding down power and all the different books and doing what you do. You know, it's
Thank you
the
so
last season,
much.
it's bittersweet, but let's hop right on in. Do you feel that the impact that power has had on entertainment, do you think that there's any other shows that can top that? What you guys did at Power.
I'm not gonna sit here and be all humble and stuff like that. I don't think it's another, there's not gonna be another show that's gonna replicate what the Power Universe did. And that's just the facts. Like, there's gonna be great shows out there, you know, this is gonna be historic and legendary shows, but what Power did, I don't think another show could replicate that. Just exactly what we did, I don't think they could replicate that.
I totally agree. And just thinking back to like when you first started, what have you learned over the years just about your own work ethic and like your
Yeah.
own capabilities? What have you learned?
Man, I learned a lot. Like, aside from just work things, like, I just learned a lot from just life, you know, just being around these great people every day, being around these great minds, and just even the scripts alone, like, you know, situations that characters go through with each other, it kind of just shows, like, kind of taught me about a lot about, like, loyalty, principles, and respect. So I learned a lot about that, and I translated that into real life. But as far as like my work and work ethic, definitely changed for me, because when they told me I was gonna be having my own spinoff, I was like, hell no, like, y'all bugging, that's not gonna happen. Nobody likes Tariq. It's over with. Like, that's not gonna happen. And then and 50 had told me, they was like, yo, they don't think that they don't think that you ready. And in my mind, I'm like, oh no, nah, they bugging. So I had to, you know, I had to change my work ethic a lot, you know. I had to get into like a mode of not even trying to prove them wrong, but just proving me and 50 Cent right. Like, 'cause 50 knew I was ready. Me, myself, I didn't really think I was ready either, but I'm like, you know what? I got no choice but to be ready. So I just kind of just took everything that was coming, and I was just like, whatever happens, happens. We gonna work though.
So would you say like you ultimately said yes to the role or like the spinoff because you had something to prove?
Nah, I say yes because, like, I had no choice. What I'm gonna do? They like, yo, we writing a TV show about you. I ain't gonna say no. I ain't gonna be like, no, let's do it. But I think I just, you know, I was just ready to, you know, kind of just, you know, just be a quarterback, you know, ready to, you know, quarterback the whole thing. At first, I was like, nobody likes Tariq, so I don't know if I'm ready. Like, I don't think anybody's even gonna watch it. I'm like, eh. But then, you know, after a while, it was just like, yo, they're gonna do it regardless, so I gotta be ready. And Courtney actually came to me second, because 50 told me first, and I thought he was joking. I was like, yeah, whatever. And Courtney came to me about like 2 weeks after that. She's like, yeah, you about to have your own show, so you gotta get ready. I said, once Courtney told me that, I was like, all right, man, let me lock in, let me get ready, let me get ready.
When you found out that this was going to be the final season, right? Do you recall like where you were, like, you know, how, where were you when this happened? Like, do you recall that day when you got the news?
I don't even know. I was probably in the crib playing a game or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. We wasn't on set. We wasn't. We finished filming. We finished filming before we knew it was gonna be the last season. So I don't even know where I was. I probably was in the crib playing a game or something. I don't know. But yeah, they told me. I was like, oh shit, why? I was like, why?
If you could kind of project, if this wasn't the final season, right? Where would you like to see Tariq go? Like, where would you have liked to see that character go?
I would have wanted to see him get up out the state or something, like, go out the country for a little bit, go, like, I don't know, go enjoy the fruits of your labor, bro. Like, you over here damn near dying almost every day, and you can't even enjoy, like, you know, whatever you working for. It's like, damn, I feel like Tariq need a little vacation, you know, a little 3-day trip to Miami, like, go there, you know what I'm saying? Like, that would have been fire. But I don't know. Like, I wanted to see Tariq actually, you know, just get a chance to be not even just a kid, just be a human.
Yeah.
Yeah, he never had no chance to be a human. He always got something going on. Like, I don't know.
Would you have seen him becoming his father, or maybe he would have took the right, you know, the good guy path? Like, what do you think?
I don't think it was no good guy pass for Tariq. Like, it was there for him, like, you know what I'm saying? It was there for him, you know, his whole life. And I just feel like he just went the route that was really meant for him. Like, when you think about it, like, he grew up around nothing but what he is now. So it's like, how could he really become anything else? He didn't have nothing else to look up to. Like, he didn't have nobody that was a college graduate that got their degree to look up to. You know what I'm saying? Like, his mentor was Kanan. Like, he was running around with Kanan all, like, from the whole three, like, the whole third season. So it's like, all of that stuff he learned from Kanan, like, what could he possibly apply that to other than the streets?
No, that
So
makes
he's
sense.
just, yeah, you know,
Definitely.
he's just in the streets, and that's, you know, he's just a product of his, you know, of his environment, product of his family.
So working with 50 Cent, because you know this is show, he's such a troll, such a jokester. Would you be a part of another 50 Cent production?
Oh yeah, 100%. Anything 50 doing, and he called me for it, count me in. That's
Love that.
anytime. That's my idol. Like, I'll never pass up an opportunity to work with 50 Cent ever in my life, ever.
I love that. I love that. So what's
Ever.
next for you? What can we expect?
Man, a lot is next for Michael. Right now, I have like a small writers team. We writing scripts. Got like two scripts right now that we're writing. Obviously auditioning. Gonna be filming something very soon. Can't speak on that, but looking forward to that. My music stuff, I've been producing, been kind of, you know, pressing the button on my producing a lot more.
If you could think of just the whole Power franchise, who would you say was like the number one villain and the number one hero?
Dre. Dre is definitely number one villain.
Okay.
Dre is the number one villain. That dude was alive for so long. Like, dude, he was raised in hell forever. I would say Dre. And then, hero.
I don't
That's
know
a
if hero's
good
the
one.
right word, but like you know what I mean.
Because it's a few, like, it's like, if you're gonna say heroes, there's a few people you could really consider heroes, though, for certain reasons. Like, I would consider Tariq a hero because he didn't let Ghost send his mom to jail. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, even though she ended up in jail anyway, it wasn't for what she would have ended up in jail for. Like, if she would have ended up in jail for Lakeisha's murder, she would have been done. Would have been no wit check, would have been no nothing for her. It would have been life in prison. But I would say Tasha's also a hero too, because she kind of saved Tariq. Like, you know, she kind of saved Tariq in a way. But yeah, number one villain is definitely Dre, though. Number
Okay.
one villain.
That's interesting. Thank you so much for your time. And I can't wait to see
Thank
the
you.
final season and see what you do next.
Oh, that's gonna be crazy. Final season is gonna be crazy, and what I do next is gonna be even crazier.